The Bernoulli distribution is the number of successes in a sequence of independent yes-no experiments. Okay, for the quiz Monday, brush up on chapters 3 and 4.
Bernoulli's one of my favorites. Little known fact, statistics were not his only love. He's also famous for his French sauce used on meat and poultry.
That's Bernays.
Oh, we may need to settle this at a restaurant.
It's cute. A little aggressive, but as a busy, confident woman of authority, I'm attracted to men who take charge.
Are you being sarcastic or am I nailing it?
You were nailing it until you had to ask.
Oh, damn it. Starting over. Hey, you in the skirt, date me.
I'd like to, Mr. Winger. You're tall, you dress nice, and I've graded enough of your tests to know I'd never feel mentally inadequate.
Thank you.
Only problem, I don't date students.
You know, if you agree to go out with... Oh, hey, awkward. How small is this campus? Barely a student. I'm older than you. I drive a Lexus. I saw Ghostbusters in the theater. Look, my gums are receding.
It's uncanny how many of my buttons you're finding, but I have a personal rule about this and I stick to it.
Have a cup of coffee with me? I bet I can change your mind.
Oh, I know you can. That's why you're not getting the chance.
There you go, pretty lady.
What are you doing here?
Showing you my non-student side.
I have to admit, this outfit's doing it for me. I may or may not have been deflowered by a junior rodeo champion.
You're reminding me of my first time, too.
You lost your virginity to Robin Hood?
No, with an attractive woman at a party. We seem destined to repeat history.
I told you no students. It's unseemly. I go out with you. You tell your friends. It gets around the school.
What friends? I have no friends. I hate everyone here but you.
Hey.
Michelle Slater, PhD.
Britta Perry, GED.
Oh, are you a classmate of Jeff's?
Oh, well, when you say classmate, it sounds like we take naps together and eat paste. But what's great about community colleges is that a lot of the students are just as mature as the teachers. Jeff! Please sleep with me. Please. Pretty please. I'm so lonely. I haven't slept with anyone in a very long time, and you are so good looking. Please do me the favor of having sex with me.
Okay, stay 3 steps behind and promise you won't tell anybody.
I promise. I promise.
No, I'm not ready to die!
Pierce, you're not gonna die! Look at me!
Don't make eye contact.
Jeff! 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 Pierce is freaking out. You're the only one that can help.
What makes you think that?
Is Jeff out there? He's the only one who can help.
He says he's gonna kill himself, but he doesn't want us to call 911 because he doesn't want to get in trouble for taking drugs.
I can't believe I'm doing this. I think I have to say goodnight.
Are you like a court-appointed guardian for these people?
No. They're my classmates.
Good night, Jeff.
Professor Slater, quick question.
You know the answer, Mr. Winger. I don't date students, even if you are no longer in my statistics class.
I'm actually kind of seeing someone right now, thank you very much.
Really? How's that going?
Fine for now. She's smart and pretty, but sometimes I feel like she's just waiting for me to stop talking and take off my pants.
She is.
I've never been someone's dirty little secret.
I've never had a dirty little secret. It's so unprofessional. But the sneaking does make the sex 38% hotter.
Wow, you do like statistics, don't you?
Hey, midterms and whatever.
Talk. Professor Slater, there's that transcript you wanted. Jeff, I didn't expect to see you here. Hopefully I'm not...
interrupting.
You know, we laugh. But the fact is, student-teacher relationships do happen, and they are a magnet for lawsuits, so we do stay vigilant. In fact, physically attractive students and faculty are actually placed on a watch list and are ranked by their potential to incite fraternization.
You rank people by how hot they are?
You got it. Number 2.
Dean Pelton.
Yes, Professor 7. Slater.
I'll return this tomorrow.
Okay, then. You guys be extra careful now. 2 people of your rankings in this smaller room, with this type of lighting and... his upper body and what her heels and hemline are doing to enhance what were already quite a few favors from God. It's all the more important to keep it tasteful.
Hey,
thinking might have ruined...
It's dead.
Mr. Winger, would you come to my office? We never finished our intercourse.
I have study group right now, and nobody uses intercourse to mean anything other than sex. Look, this is a wall of windows. My study group is behind it.
I know.
Look, as soon as we touch, the blinds will open, and six annoying but lovable misfits will be staring at us.
Come on, what are the odds?
Fine.
No, is that so bad?
Hey! Could you open the back door?
You all remember Michelle Slater, my professor from last semester? As most of you may realize by now, she's the woman I've been seeing lately.
Why are they looking at me like I'm a zoo animal?
Well, Jeff X is sort of the dad of the group, so emotionally this is kind of like being told that you're a new mom.
But you know it's nothing like that, right?
Absolutely. Do you cook macaroni?
I have.
Macaroni's my favorite.
The important thing is, we all understand, Professor Slater and I need this to be our little secret. Everyone understand that?
Macaroni's my favorite.
The pepper jack cheese.
Sure.
It's so good. The pepper jack, and you bake it.
See?
You know.
All good.
Well, thank you, everyone. I appreciate it. I should get going.
Oh.
Hi.
Hi.
Well,
chaperoning tomorrow's dance. You should come. Maybe your study buds will go. What's the blonde's name? Bitter, butter, Beetlejuice?
Britta, yeah, she says Valentine's Day ritualizes a connection between affection and candy so girls can learn the ropes of prostitution.
Translation, no date.
I'm gonna join you at that dance. But as a novice boyfriend, can I get a map of the minefield known as women's Valentine expectations?
Every day of the year, I want you to do what makes you happy.
Tomorrow, I'm going to be happy spending the night with an insatiable statistics professor.
Hey there. Happy Valentine's Day. I've been calling you.
Yeah, I know. I figured I'd just let it go to voicemail in case you had the wrong number again.
Elaborate?
Oh, you don't remember calling me at 4 a.m. and hanging up when you realized I wasn't Britta? I guess not.
Michelle. Michelle, I was trying to call Britain to order you toffees. Now, that may sound dumb, but I needed to open with it to make the truth less ridiculous. Two nights ago, Britta drunk dialed me, and it embarrassed her and made her sad. And the only way for her to get her power back was for me to get believably drunk and leave her an equally embarrassing message.
It sure seems like you and Britta are friends, the way my mom's pool cleaner was my uncle. Have you had sex with her?
Not even a little.
What doesn't make sense is that you did all this work to put a smile on her face, but you can't pick up ice cream for Law and Order night because it feels too raragey.
First of all, chubby hubby? I mean, could you pick a scarier flavor?
Let's talk about this later. I need to chaperone something.
Sorry, just chaperoning, enjoy the dance.
Wait, Michelle.
Jeff. What's left to say?
I don't know.
I do. He said it last night.
So look, I am really into Michelle, and I don't want to screw it up. She's a perfect girlfriend. And I want you to be as happy as me because you're like my favorite friend. I'm sorry. Abed just made a turtle face.
In his defense, Abed's turtle face is really funny. Thanks, Britta.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah. That was just 20 seconds of a 40-minute message.
Very informative.
Happy Valentine's Day. Perfect boyfriend.
Yeah, that's me.
Haven't seen you all day.
I've been really busy, plus I had to find like 30 extra chairs for my classroom since it's family day.
Oh, speaking of, I was going to invite my mom so you could meet her, but she still thinks I'm a lawyer. Oh, look, a human being has a little human with it. How blood-curdlingly adorable.
Jeff, we need to talk.
What's wrong? Are you breaking up with me?
Oh, maybe we don't need to talk.
jefe.
Sweet.
You know what, jefe?
You probably don't want to talk to me.
Not junior high. We're mature adults, Michelle. We can talk.
I think I handled our breakup poorly.
Before I respond to that, I'll have to take an extra strength vitamin duh. Duh.
We started getting serious and I got scared, and it's possible I made a mistake. Maybe we can talk about it sometime. I miss you.
Mm-mm. Just take a picture, it'll last longer.
Cool.
Oh, Professor Slater, hi, what are you doing here?
Oh, you know, end of the year, randomly wandering. Hi, Jeff.
Are you two?
No.
The two of you aren't.
No. Just friends.
Same here.
Good. For you.
Will I see you at the dance, Britta?
Kind of obligated, seeing as I'm nominated for queen, so.
Oh, I thought you were all into female empowerment.
What's more empowering than a woman in a crown?
Hi, Jeff.
Oh.
Britta, you look great. Such a stunning improvement.
Wow, you look gorgeous. It must have taken all day.
Oh, Jeff, you've got a...
Oh,
it's right there.
I do.
Actually,
none of them. No, it's good. Guys, cleanest face ever.
Hey, am I okay?
Yes.
Yeah.
Good evening, Michelle. Or may I say, meow, Shell.
Who has your car keys?
They're in the taco meat. Now, what say you and I blow this pop stand and head off for a spot of slap and tickle? I mean sex, in case the lingo hasn't made it to the States.
I think I'm probably leaving here with Jeff.
Really? I'm sorry, I just assumed that you two were done since, Jeff and Britta did, the Yankee Doodle. Oh, don't tell me that didn't make it to the States. It clearly originated here.
Okay, we finished tallying all 36 votes, so everyone get ready!
Yo, Goldilocks. Drop the smirk. I know about your grungy tumble, and I'm sure it was the highlight of your diary, but it was during a pit stop in something real.
You were the pit stop. He used you to numb the pain of not getting with me. Jeff needs a girl who doesn't just not wear underwear because Oprah told her it would spice things up. He needs a girl who doesn't wear underwear because she hasn't done laundry in 3 weeks. He's been to flavor country now. They should retire the table we did it on.
The table?
Miss Britta Perry!
Oh, I'm sorry. I have to go. I just won a contest for being hot.
Very fatal attraction.
Do you love me?
I have something to say. Jeff, I love you.
I wonder where she got that from.
I'm sorry, do you have a patent on loving people?
Would you like a patent in getting your ass kicked?
Like a dividend?
Okay. Can you stand over there? And can you sit down, please? Jeffrey, choose Britta.
Yeah, Team Britta. Yeah.
Britta's lame. Team Slater. Yeah.
Bring Conan back.